Happy Monday to everybody. It is Monday, November 23rd, the week of Thanksgiving here in the States. Let me get the lights figured out here. There we go. Hope you're all well. Okay, so this topic came up last week. We're doing a live, and again, I apologize for Friday's live. I was in my car running errands. I'm like so close to being done with all of my holiday shopping, like so close. Not even Thanksgiving yet. I'm really scared about stuff getting like sold out and gone. Anyway, this question came up a couple times when I was doing a live Q&A Friday. So let me just bring this question back up here because this is a really good one. I don't kind of know how we got there, but my feed cut out. And so I want to make sure that we tackle this right away together. So first up, this podcast thing. Let's just talk about this. What's up? Leticia, good to see you. Let's talk about the podcast in general, or being in other people's, I guess you could say, even in blogs, LinkedIn Live stuff, Facebook Live stuff, podcasts. If it's a blog, if it's a virtual summit, there's so many places that people are putting together digital day. They have been for a long time. Nothing new about that. But right now, obviously, that's kind of in hyper mode. Everybody's just go, go, go. So how do you get on someone's podcast and how do you actually market and sell through someone else's podcast? Now, I've had a podcast in the past. It was on a completely different topic. The topic of hope. It's called I Share Hope. I interviewed a bunch of people, leaders from around the world, 125 leaders around the world, asking them questions about hope. I was in a dark place. Podcasting, like, was one of the major things that helped bring me out of a lot of depression and anxiety and all that kind of stuff that I was dealing with 7-8 years ago. All right. That was my podcasting experience. It has nothing to do with business and marketing and running an agency, nothing like that. I don't have a podcast now, and yet I'm still on a ton of podcasts. And here's how you do it. It's not hard. You don't need to have your own podcast. And being on someone else's, what's up? It's good to see you. Being on someone else's podcast is way, way easier than having your own podcast. This is kind of like, you know, you want to have a next door neighbor with a swimming pool or a next door neighbor with a boat in a lake house, but you don't want to have a boat in a lake house or a pool because then you got to take care of it. Same thing with podcasting. So I love not having a podcast. I've had in the past. It was a great experiment. It was great fun, but it was a lot of work. All right. And honestly, I did not get the results or have not experienced the results from having my own show in different genres the same way as being in other people's shows. All right, so let's talk about why you'd want to be on someone else's podcast first up. And then let's talk about the kind of the obvious question of would they want you on their podcast if you don't have one that you can host them on as well? Laura, great to see you. Good morning. Denver's looking good. Looks like you're getting some great snow and some great weather. Wish I was there. So let's do this. Podcasting, why? First up, being involved in someone else's audience is the obvious play, right? So you're getting out there, you're getting to put your voice, your message, your face, if it's video also, all the things you talk about, your expertise into someone else's audience. You get to help other people, and other people get to get introduced to you. People get to know about you that would have never come across your path because they're already paying attention to that host. Mike, great to see you, dude. So that's the real reason. That's obviously the reason. That's why we'd be on other people's shows, right? Podcasts. If they're interviewing you for a written blog, if it's a virtual summit, whatever it is, it's just that much simpler. that's right, Laura. I wish I was there for real. Okay, Mike, I love hosting my podcast. So many great conversations and connections. Awesome. So Mike's the guy who loves hosting his own podcast. Fantastic. Mike's the guy with the swimming pool or with the boat in the lake house. And you can borrow Mike's pool. Mike, I was just saying how I don't like having a podcast. I used to, and I love borrowing other people's because it's just easier to let you do the work. So thanks for doing that. No, seriously, though, having your own podcast is a great way to influence your market and build a following. And obviously, Mike's got great expertise, and he's able to speak into the world he serves. And that's a great place to do that. But being on other people's podcasts is really easier than you think. So what we do as a team is we reach out to other podcast hosts. They could be vlog, podcast, bloggers, or people who are hosting virtual summits, right? We reach out to those people, or they reach out to us. When we first started out, we were doing most of the outreach. Now people reach out to us as well, and we still do outreach. It's no mystery that you have to do outreach. Getting on people's podcasts, no matter where you are in your career cycle as an expert, you're still going to be prospecting and asking to be on someone else's podcast because there's still audiences that you want to approach that may not be approaching you. There's nothing shameful about asking if you can be on someone's podcast. It's just the way it works. It's prospecting, right? We all get it. We're all in the sick game together. Cool. Mike, you love doing podcast swaps too. We'll talk about that in a second. That's great. David, just recording episode 21 of our podcast. Way to go, David. Have not tried having guests yet, though. The whole guest thing is a whole different thing, David. You'll love it. Just a different structure. So ultimately, getting on someone else's podcast is as simple as sending out an email or a message on LinkedIn or Facebook or directly on their website page for their podcast. Just letting them know, and be for real about this, though. Go out there and find people who are talking about the topics that you're an expert in as well. Or they have a market that you know that would dovetail well into your expertise. You could actually give and bring real value to their space in the market. That's what you're looking for. So, for instance, if you are an expert at, I'm just gonna take something completely off marketing for a second or agency-oriented stuff. Let's say you're an expert at pet grooming. Okay. And there's so many podcasts about pet training, right? You would be an amazing guest on a pet training podcast as a pet groomer, because the people who are doing pet training are also thinking about pet grooming. So you're not jumping in there and selling your pet training services when a host is already trying to sell his or her pet training services. You're bringing something that's complementary to that market. So in business or marketing or agency or consulting, whatever it is that you do in this space, if you're on a podcast and you're wanting to be on a podcast of a coach who does business mindset success coaching, awesome. If you're in any of the marketing, business, outgoing communication genres, you would be a complement to that coach's audience. So very simple way to see that. Look for places that you can actually add real value, a complimentary piece of advice or service or expertise without conflicting with the authors or the current leaders' place in that market, all right? I let people talk on my show, and even in this Facebook group, you'll see that I let people come in and talk in this Facebook group, and I don't take any commission, any affiliate, nothing like that, that are even in competition technically with me. It's okay. There's so many fish in the sea. I just want you, my audience, to be helped so you can move forward. I don't care if someone else gets the deal. To me, that's less important. Helping others is the primary goal here, and good things always come from that. So just get out there and find a place you can speak and offer your expertise and complement an existing host's market. Complement what they're doing. Add to it. Bring extra value. Find that. Then shoot that message out. All right. Put together a little message to the host, and you can copy paste 80% of this. But basically, you're just introducing yourself, a little bio at the end of your message. But really, that first thing up there is you just want to introduce yourself. For instance, I'm just going to use Mike here as an example, since Mike has his own show. Mike Brennan here. So I would just simply say, and Mike, my apologies, I don't recall what your show is about, but let's just go with this. So I would say in my little message, hey, Mike, this is Chris Williams. I see that you're an expert in XYZ, and I am an expert in this right here. Would love a chance to speak to your audience, be on your podcast, offer any advice I can to your market. I know we don't compete in this space, but I think our connected expertise would really add value to your market. Something like that. And then I throw a little bio. Here's a little more about me if you're interested. And then I throw even two or three topics in. Hey, here's a couple of topics that I could cover, or a couple of topics I've covered recently in other shows, or whatever it is. Just get a few relevant ideas that you've got that you're like, hey, I could speak into that person's market. And here's a few things I could really add value with. Just again, topics that you can just truly give, and just send those invitations out. That's it. Email, Facebook message, LinkedIn message, however you connect to this podcast leader. Even if you don't know them from anybody, you don't have to have a connection, just send them out. You'll be surprised at how many come back and say, hey, that's actually interesting. I was thinking about that with my team the other day. Let's have a quick Zoom call and just talk it out. Let me get to know you. Like, that happens all the time for us. We send out invitations and it works. All right. The more you do that, the more shows you'll get on. And yes, it's just like prospecting. Some people will ghost you. You won't get any response. No worries. Some people will say, no, thank you. I've never had anybody reply back with any kind of rudeness. They're all professionals. They have shows. But it's just a simple way to get to know people. And a decent percentage of them, I don't know the percentage, but it's like easily more than half, say yes. So that's really straightforward. It's really easy. And the more you do that, the more you'll start getting invitations to be on other people's shows and other people's virtual summits, get interviewed for their blog, whatever they want to do, because they're going to hear you as a guest on Mike's, Mike's on creativity. Great. On Mike's podcast about creativity. And let's say I'm going to talk about being a creative and running a business. All right. So my pitch to Mike, since he has a podcast on creativity, would be on how to be a creative thinker and still structure a business. All right. Great. So maybe that would be relevant to Mike's market. If it would, yay, we're connected now. Right. So with that in mind, then other people who are creatives that are also leaning in and listening to Mike as their expert are going to hear me, and they're going to invite me to be on their podcast. It just keeps going round and round. It's really, really fun. Once you kind of get that thing moving, it's like any other good prospecting and marketing tool. It starts to kind of work for you. It takes a few months, totally worth doing. So that's how we get on podcasts, okay? Pretty straightforward. It's prospecting. Be authentic. Be real. Find a place that you could really add value and see if you can reach out there and help someone. Use that little scripting I just gave you. It works. It's really straightforward. It's easier than you think. Now, what do you actually do? How do you actually convert? This kind of part two of this question was, how do you actually prospect and get sales and actually make something productive out of being a guest on someone else's podcast, right? Because it is great to help out the market, but you really also want to make sure that you're sustainable, right? Everybody's got to make a living. Nobody fusses at that. That's reality. So here's what I do. Number one, like I've already said, the goal is to give, give, give. Add real value. I never let someone come on my show, and I'm never on someone else's show without really adding complete value. I want to hand something to the people listening that's not just like a tantalizing little nugget of truth, but they have to jump over here to this funnel and get my free plus shipping book or whatever in order to, no, I'm not into that. I want to give them a real package wrapped up with a bow on it. Here you go, start to finish. Do this and you can start getting traction today kind of message. All right, answering questions they come up, but I want to make sure they can go from start to finish and actually do something. Like right now, delivering this about how to go out and get on a podcast and how to actually market and actually convert that into sales. This is literally how to do it. I've shown you, here's how to go find a few places you can get on podcast. Here's how to go, and here's the scripting you can do, and here's what I talk about. Like, I'm trying to give you enough where you can really go get started. I don't have a product for sale. I don't have an online course for sale for you to go learn how I do prospecting via podcast. I'm just trying to give you the honest truth. Here's how it works, okay? I do that on podcasts as well. You can do the same. Pick a topic, pick a section of space that you can talk to and give into where people can really take action based on what you're going to say. Laura, give value. Yes. If you talk about yourself and don't share value, your interview will never air in my show. It's not about you. Yeah, Laura, great advice. Laura's a great podcaster and had a radio show for a decade. She's legit. So get out there, add real value, make something happen for those listeners. Give them hope, give them power, give them steps, give them things they can do to succeed right now when the show's over. Okay, next, I give them a place to find me, all right? It's that simple, all right? It can be, hey, you can join my Facebook community. Hey, you can find me on LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Here's my website, my branding site, my whatever site. Here's where to go. If it's a funnel that you've got, if it's a classic funnel, like to a webinar, to something you might sell, if it's an info about you website, if it's your done for you service, if it's a Facebook community lead, if it's a large Instagram following or a LinkedIn following or whatever, fantastic. If it's a link back to your podcast, your book, whatever, whatever's fine. They know you're there to bring people in. But the people who are listening, who are like, oh my gosh, this person really helped me, those are the ones who are going to lean in and want to know more about you. They're going to engage. They're going to go wherever you are. And don't get stuck with thinking, well, I can't get on someone's podcast until I have this amazing funnel built out, or my website's not quite done yet, or I promise you it doesn't matter. Literally say, hey, if you want to connect with me more, would love to hear from anybody, because the host always says, how can we connect to you, Chris? How can people find out more about you? Hey, if you want to connect more, no worries. Just hit me up on Facebook. I'm in there quite a bit. Or on LinkedIn. Here's my handle. Chris Williams HQ. You know, boom, done. That's it. People will find you, they want to find you. They will link, they'll reach out, they'll drop you a little message, and they'll say, hey, heard you on so-and-so's podcast. Thanks so much. Or they might be more direct and say, hey, heard about this. Thanks so much. Can we talk more about this? Can you help my agency with this? Whatever. They will reach out and make connection. Once that happens, then you're off to the races and you can start building that relationship, okay? So you don't have to have a fancy funnel, a group, anything official to send people to. just simply get out there and help people and make connections, okay? Yeah, if you do have something fancy to send them to, you might harvest a little more. You might get a few more people locked in. You might build a little more into your list, whatever. But don't let that hold you back from getting out there and being on podcasts and helping people. Excuse me. The value you bring to the market, the people that you help, are the ones that really, really are going to lean in on you. And the sooner you start, the sooner you get that whole marketing wheel moving in the podcast space. And that's the most important piece here, not your landing page. David, what about podcasts that are generally about interesting topics versus specific industry-related topics? Yeah, you know, David, most of the podcasts I personally listen to are more about interesting topics, hobbies, or they're about completely random topics that I didn't even know I was interested in, but I just love the host and the way they present a topic and think through it or whatever. So yeah, if it's that kind of thing, let's say it's somebody who's a world traveler, or a life hacker in general. I'm thinking Tim Ferriss. Tim Ferriss is a good example of that. Tim Ferriss is so all over the place on his topics. I don't even know if the dude's still podcasting. I haven't listened to his stuff in 5 years probably. But all over the place, but still really great person to listen to. But at that level, obviously he brings superstars on his show all the time, but at that level of engagement, gotta be pretty high. But even somebody who's lower down there, if it's just random topics that are all over the place, if their market aligns with your market, meaning for instance, Tim Ferriss's market would be a good example. Tim Ferriss has an unusually high amount of entrepreneurs in his podcast audience. I know that from doing some research. And it's because he's a life hacker. So he's not really focused on entrepreneurship, but people who are focused on entrepreneurship are also life hackers. So when you find those connections, still a great place to invite yourself to. If you've got something that's relevant to that market that would entertain them and would help get the host out, go for it. Invite yourself, right? Regarding coming above, specifically referring to my own podcast, we speak more about mindset, life principles, and interesting topics more than specifically web design or marketing. Cool. Yeah, so David, I would think if you had guests in there who, mindset, life principles, and interesting topics, if you had guests in there, and David, let me just, again, so sorry, this is not me pitching my podcast voice into you and Mike's podcast a second ago. Tom, what's up? But let me just pitch it as if I was doing it, because I know my product and now I know your product well. So if you're speaking to mindset, life principles, and interesting topics more than specifically web design or marketing, even though I own a web design and marketing agency, most of the work I do as an individual is mindset and really life hacking and really understanding the principles that help us live, not just do business. So my agency actually hasn't built a website in quite a while because we don't do that anymore. We've outsourced it. We figured out the principles and the mindset and the process of life that we want to experience. And then we've let our business fund and feed that versus being a web design company. So I could speak to your market, even though I'm focused on building agencies and efficiency and building coaching programs, things like that. I could speak to your market on the mindset and the principles that go into being an entrepreneur and having a life that you want to have and letting the business actually set that up for you. That's kind of a stretch, but you see where I'm going. Look for ways that you can make those connections. You being a guest on other people's shows, David, would be fantastic because every business coach, everybody out there needs mindset help. And you being an expert on that and having a show about mindset would be a fantastic way for you to speak into somebody else's audience too. Always an open door in the mindset space, for sure. So, okay, so there you go. Get out there, find speakers, hosts that you actually believe that you can help their audience, okay? Not by competing with the host, but by bringing another voice to that, another topic, another view of a topic that helps support what the host is already doing, and send a quick email like I mentioned in a little bit of scripting a few minutes ago that just lets them know, hey, I'm Chris, would love to be on your show because I see that you're helping people like this. This is also who I speak to, but I'm not competing with you. I would actually love to support your conversation and add to it with these kind of topics. Here's two or three things I could talk about. If you want to know a little more about me, here's a short bio of me. Would love to connect some time on a quick call and see if it's a good fit. Something super open like that, you'll get responses. Email that out, Facebook it out, Instagram message, LinkedIn message, whatever. Just reach out to the host and send them a message like that. Once you get on there, give real solid 100% value where it's start to finish. Somebody could take what you've talked about and start doing something that day with that advice. And then the host will always ask, how can they connect? Again, you don't have to have a fancy landing page or some amazing spot to go to. Just simply give them the social media handle of your choice and let them find you and engage in a conversation. Start doing that and you'll start getting a little more traffic, a little more leads into wherever you send people, even if it's just a simple Facebook profile. And you'll start building more practice, more brand, more recognition in more audiences. And after several months of doing that, meaning one or two of those a week, I would basically be trying to send out like 10 invitations a week. And then once you start doing that, after about a month or so, maybe 6 weeks, you'll start getting on the books. You'll have 5 to 6 podcast or some type of interview booked per week. That kind of energy and that kind of forward momentum really does work. Laura, usually the VA will send an application, easy peasy. Yep, absolutely. We get a lot of applications back and we send this kind of asks out and somebody on my team fills them out and answers the questions the best they can. So, hope that helps. Great question that came up Friday. Any other questions about that? I'll go in just about a couple minutes. I have one more point I want to cover, but if there's any more questions, make sure you fire them off here before I wrap it up. Excuse me. Tomorrow we have, this is kind of really cool. Tomorrow we have a guest on my show. Great example of this right here in this Facebook community, Lead Agency Inner Circle. I have a bookkeeper coming on to talk about year-end financial stuff. I know. Oh my gosh, Chris, that's painful. Really? There's not many bookkeepers you meet out there in the world who can actually communicate and make it fun at the same time. This one can. So she's coming on tomorrow. I won't tell your name until tomorrow and I'll introduce her. But this one's coming on tomorrow. She's fantastic and she'll help us really look at year end. And then we're also going to have her on again in January and she's going to help us with tax planning for the U.S. tax calendar, at least, which would be starting in January and kind of getting up into April. Because our goal is to help you understand, hey, here's a few things you should be thinking about. If you're going to make expenses happen, if you're going to be moving money in and out of your business account, whatever, here's what you need to know by the end of the year. And then once we get to that stage, here's what you can look at and kind of plan for next year as you're doing your taxes and getting your books figured out, getting organized, things like that. Okay. Yay. Sounds fun. I know, Laura, right? Talking money tomorrow. Thanks for the tag. Yvonne, it's great to see you. Fantastic question. Great topic. Thanks for bringing that up Friday. CN, bookkeeping is super helpful. Yeah. I'm hoping she'll talk through a little bit of like the apps we can use as well. I personally use QuickBooks for all of our agencies, both agencies, the Elite Agency stuff, and my Done For You service for surgeons that y'all and I run. Those two agencies both run through QuickBooks. But there are some really cool apps out there. If you're not sure what to use, there's some really simple stuff you can use on your phone or you can get fancier, you know. But just so you get away from the spreadsheets and try to use a real accounting app, it really does help. A lot of them are free and super simple to do that. But anyway, tomorrow, 10 a.m. Central, we'll dive into bookkeeping. We'll try not to geek out on it too much, but we definitely want to dive in enough to get you guys help for year end. Okay, I'm out of here. Y'all have a fantastic Monday. We'll talk Tuesday. See you guys. Let's see. There we go. Okay. Now I'll see you guys. Bye.